Hey everybody, it's Christopher Small, the owner of CMS Law Firm. We do estate planning, we do probate, we do it well. Today, I want to talk to you about how to fund a testamentary trust. Before I get to that though, I want to remind you, if you have questions about this or anything else related to estate planning or probate, and you want to talk with us over the phone for free, you can go to cmslawfirm.com. Okay, how to fund a testamentary trust. Let's start at the beginning. What is a testamentary trust? A testamentary trust is a trust that is located inside of your will. Okay, so if you have a will, and inside of the will, it mentions creating a trust when you die, this would be called a testamentary trust. Now, before we go any further, I want to let you know, testamentary trusts are terrible, okay? They suck. And you're gonna hear why in a minute when it comes to funding them. But one of the main advantages of a trust, one of the great things about revocable living trust is what we're really talking about, is you can avoid probate when you create a trust, okay? The way that this works is you create this trust. It is alive and kicking while you are also alive. You put your property into your trust while you're alive. You have all the control and flexibility with your property. It stays exactly the same. But when you die, because the trust holds the property, there's no need to transfer that property anywhere else. You just have a new person step in that to manage the trust, follow your guidelines regarding the trust, and then they distribute the property as you have laid out. There's no need to go through probate, which is essentially the process of transferring your property to some other place, okay? Now, with a testamentary trust, there is a problem in that the trust doesn't actually exist. It's not created until you die, okay? So to fund that trust, you have to move assets into the trust after you die. But the only way to do that is through probate, okay? You die, the trust is created, then your assets are moved into the trust at that time via probate. I'm not gonna say that some attorneys are sneaky for creating testamentary trusts, but some attorneys are sneaky for creating testamentary trusts. In my opinion, the only reason that you would put a trust inside of a will is because you as the attorney wanna catch a probate fee on the back end. That's really the only reason, because it's not significantly harder to just create a standalone trust. There's no maintenance, there's no taxes, there's no real reason for a client not to want to create a standalone revocable living trust. Okay, if you have a testamentary trust though, and you're cool with that, the way that you have to fund that trust is not by naming. So typically what you're gonna do is you're gonna have to have beneficiary designations on your accounts, on life insurance policies and all these things. You're going to have to either have no beneficiary designated, so all of those, that account will pour into your estate and then be transferred into your trust via probate, or you will name as your beneficiary my estate. I had a conversation yesterday with a potential client who had a testamentary trust, who thought that they were doing the right thing, and then they were confused by the fact that if they had beneficiary designations of their family members, that the trust wouldn't be functional at all when they were gone. The reason is, when you name a beneficiary on an account, that account goes directly to the person that you have named. So if you don't name the trust, if you have a standalone trust, or if you don't name your estate, if you have a testamentary trust, then the funds, the asset that you have named in that transfer, in that beneficiary designation, are going to go to the person that you have named, okay? So to sort of summarize and repeat real quick, because I know I talk fast. If you have a testamentary trust, the way that you fund it is by pouring all of your assets into your estate after you die, opening a probate, taking all of those assets via the probate, and then transferring them into your testamentary trust. And again, a testamentary trust is a trust that is inside of a will, not a standalone trust, all right? If you have a standalone trust, you're going to just name the trust as the beneficiary on your accounts, and when you die, everything just pours in there automatically. No probate is necessary at that time. All right, so hopefully this helped. Hopefully this made sense. I want to make sure this is clear, because it wasn't clear to the people I was talking about yesterday. And it's a very important thing that you want to do, because Even if you have a testamentary trust, if you want that thing to work, you've got to put assets inside of the trust. Otherwise, you made it for literally for no reason, okay? So that is it for today. Hopefully this made sense. If it did and you liked it, hit the like button. If you're around, if you have a question or comment, please leave it wherever you're at. I'm happy to answer it. And again, if you want more information about this or anything else related to estate planning or probate, and you want to talk with us over the phone for free, you can do so by going to cmslawfirm.com. All right, that is it. As always, I am Christopher Small. I'm the owner of CMS Law Firm. We do estate planning. We do probate. We do it well. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your attention. I appreciate you, and I will talk to you again soon. See ya.